Rupert Murdoch is getting married again.
Media mogul preparing to walk down the aisle for a fifth time.
The 92-year-old billionaire announcing his engagement to 66-year-old Anne Lesley Smith, telling his tabloid, The New York Post,
"We're both looking forward to spending the second half of our lives together."
It will be a late summer wedding for the couple. Murdoch has six kids from his first three marriages. Prudence McLeod with his first wife, Patricia Booker. Elizabeth, Lachlan and James with his second wife, Anna Mann. And Grace and Chloe with his third wife, Wendy Den. He divorced his fourth wife, Jerry Hall, last year. So while we wait for Succession Season 4, across the Pacific, Murdoch's media empire is under pressure. His company News Corp controls almost two-thirds of Aussie newspapers and is facing calls for a royal commission into its dominance.
As you know, Murdoch is a cancer on our Australian democracy.
Former Liberal PM Malcolm Turnbull today announcing he'll take the reins from former Labor PM Kevin Rudd in the campaign to end Murdoch's powerful monopoly.
We have to recognise this is not a normal media organisation. This is a vehicle for political propaganda. It isn't tethered to reality or to facts or to truth.
And the jewel in Murdoch's American empire, Fox News, is staring down a $1.6 billion lawsuit.
Rupert Murdoch is admitting that some Fox News hosts endorsed false allegations by former President Trump and his allies that the 2020 presidential election was stolen.
This was the most dangerously consequential lie ever told in American political history. And it was told, amplified, spread by Fox News at a time when its controllers, including Rupert Murdoch, knew it to be a lie. This is gnawing away, tearing away at our democracy.
There's only one Rupert that we know.
Author and journalist Paddy Manning wrote a biography on Lachlan Murdoch and has dug deeper than most into this Succession sequel, and he joins us now. Paddy, Rupert only finalised his divorce from Jerry Hall last year. She blamed the kids for driving a wedge between the pair. What do you think the kids will make of his dad's new fiancée?
They were concerned. There was concerns among the kids that there was a kind of brewing, division, I suppose, between the Murdoch kids on the one hand and the Jerry's kids to Mick Jagger, Jerry Hall's kids to Mick Jagger, who were... treating the Murdoch family fortune a bit like an ATM, according to the Murdoch kids.
Really?
And so there was a kind of meeting last year, as I was told, and was reported in some of the UK gossip websites that, Jerry had met with the Murdoch children and had, raised the concern about how much money would she be getting when Rupert passed away, as he inevitably will. And that certainly raised alarm bells for the Murdoch kids, in particular for Lachlan Murdoch, as I understand, who took an instrumental kind of role in advising his father that maybe he needed to put an end to his marriage to Jerry. And I think that came as a shock to everyone outside the family, but actually it had been building up inside the family for a little while.
Gosh, Paddy, you know a lot about them, don't you? You really do.
I'm actually getting a PhD in the history of News Corporation, so I'll be a paid-up Murdochologist by the time that's done.
Now, listen, I don't want to sound like Jerry Hall, but we need to talk about the succession. So, even though it's not nice to dwell on the demise of Rupert Murdoch, who is the heir and how will that handover play out?
Well, there's no question that Lachlan Murdoch is the successor for now. My book is titled The Successor. I've got a... Well, there he is. and that's because at the moment he is the undisputed successor. Among the four children from Rupert's first two marriages, that's Prue, Elizabeth, Lachlan and James, who sit alongside Rupert on the Murdoch Family Trust. So without getting too technical, there's four votes that Rupert holds and one each on the Murdoch Family Trust that is held by each of the those four kids. When Rupert dies, those four votes that he holds that he holds will expire. Once Rupert passes, then it's a tussle between the four kids. And one of the things I was able to report in my book is that there was a determination from the other three Murdoch siblings to reassert control of the Murdoch Family Trust. And at that point, Lachlan's succession could be challenged.
So hang on, so then Lachlan's not at all the guaranteed successor? Because if it can't be handed to him when Rupert's still alive, and then once Rupert isn't it's just up for grabs and there'll be power moves.
And what about the Deng children? Do they get a vote?
No, they absolutely don't. No, that
really?
Took years of dispute within the family. No. That was one thing that the Murdoch, all four of the elder Murdoch children and their mother, they were determined that the any kids that Rupert and Wendy Deng had would never have control of the media empire. And that dispute went on for years. So they are financial beneficiaries of the Murdoch Family Trust, those two children who are now grown up, Grace and Chloe, but they do not have a vote.
I think you've earned this PhD in the Murdoch with that kind of level of detail. I wanted to talk about, like, Murdoch on the world stage because I know he's kind of, a lot of people think he's kind of this evil man, but sometimes when I read about him or I watch things about him, I have a huge sense of pride as an Australian. Like, because he kind of just took over the world. He's an Aussie battler. It's nice to be recognised on the world. You know, people are talking about Australia. Do you think in any way we should be proud of Murdoch?
I think Rupert Murdoch's story is incredible. I mean, I've seen him described as one of the two most significant Australians of the 20th century, the other being Germaine Greer, interestingly enough. No other Australian, arguably, has had such an impact on the world, for better or worse. So, of course, you have to admire some of the trademark brilliance that Rupert Murdoch has shown over the years.
Paddy, great to speak. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
Got to be everyone's dream to marry a 92-year-old billionaire. Like, nothing... How lucky could you get?
Well, like, he says he wants to share the second half of his life.
How long did he live
to be 180?
Yeah.
Which current indications seem to be quite possible that he may. Yeah. You know what I find interesting? You know this whole thing about the Murdoch press and their undoubted huge influence that they have over political decisions in this country. But the two former prime ministers who are protesting about it, Kevin Rudd and now Malcolm Turnbull, how did they get elected?
Do you want to turn it into this conversation?
No, well, how did they? If Murdoch has just such a evil, massive pull, and I'm not arguing that he doesn't, I'm like, well, you guys got elected.
Yeah, but I don't think they're saying what he says goes. I think they're just saying that he distorts democracy. It doesn't mean one else can win.
Right.
So
democracy's still working?
Well, that depends on what you think democracy means. But if you look, for example, at the American situation, I think what they're saying is that's distorting democracy because what you're getting is misinformation put out there and you're shifting sort of the centre of gravity of politics. You may agree or disagree with that. That's up to you. But what I mean, I don't think they're saying no one who Murdoch doesn't like can get elected. I don't think they're making that argument.
Okay. Guys, I think we're missing the point. A 92-year-old man got mad. Like, are you kidding? Like, that's a funny thing to talk about.